From the triumph of an inspiring new CD to the tragedy of her missing boyfriend, it's been a year of highs and lows for Olivia Newton-John. But according to the title of her new album, she's stronger than before. Please welcome Olivia Newton-John. In the back, we were talking about divorce and what happens with the kids and how you parent when you've gone through a divorce. And you did go through one. You have a daughter. How old is she?
She's 19.
19.
Yeah. What's her name?
Chloe.
Chloe, oh, how pretty.
I love that name. She's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous.
Yeah.
Gorgeous
she's
and talented.
So do you,
yeah, she's going to have an album coming out.
That's
she's
right,
really, really talented singer. She's wonderful. Mm-hmm.
Do you have any advice for parents who maybe are going through that process right now? What should they do? What shouldn't they do?
Well, I agree with Joy. You have to maintain a friendship, even though it sometimes is very painful. I managed to do that with Chloe's dad, and we're friends, and he remarried, and they come over for Christmas dinner occasionally, and we see each other, and it's not about your problems. You've got to maintain a respectful relationship for the children, so they learn to grow up and respect their partners and see that it can be done with grace. And I learned that from my mother, because my father remarried and had two children, and my mother sent gifts to the new babies when they were born, and I always remember that as being a very classy thing to do.
Absolutely, yeah. We want to talk about your album, but before we do, we mentioned that your longtime boyfriend, Patrick McDermott, disappeared while on a fishing trip last June. Everybody obviously wants to know how you are holding up through all of this, and if there's any clue as to where he might be or what's happened. Or...
As you can imagine, it's really a very, very, very difficult thing to go through. Hard to talk about, and I've chosen not to because it is painful and because there's a young son involved and a lot of speculation, but we know nothing, and it's still under investigation.
I can't imagine a greater stress to be under than to have someone who's missing and not know where they are. It's got to be one of the worst stress things that can happen to a person.
It is. It's very it's very shocking because you can, you know, in the beginning I was just kind of frozen, and then, you know, life, you have to move forward a little bit, which is one of the reasons that I decided to sing again. I didn't think I was going to sing again, but I had to move forward, and particularly after recording this album, which is all about going through difficulty and coming out the other end, I had to walk the walk, so...
Probably very therapeutic, actually.
In a way, I only started, we've done four shows, and the audiences have been so beautiful, and I've just felt their hearts, and it's been really
And you were bestowed some kind of an honor by Queen Elizabeth, I heard?
I got an OBE.
Are you a dame?
Yes. Not yet, has been said.
What's an
OBE is the Order of the British Empire.
Oh,
yes,
that's
very classy thing, you know.
Do they touch you on the shoulder and stuff like that?
Well, I met her and she was wearing pink cashmere and pearls, and it was in Buckingham Palace, and I was given a medal, which I've never worn, because when are you going to wear it? I couldn't wear it out here.
You can certainly wear it out here.
You can wear it right here.
We love it.
It was 13 years ago that you were diagnosed with breast cancer, and you were one of the first celebrities to actually come forward with that information to the public, but I read that it wasn't by choice. You were actually pretty much forced to make it public. What happened?
Yes. Well, one of the tabloid press got hold of it. I guess they have people in the radiology departments and such. And
that's disgusting.
They were, they called me and said, we're going to print this big story. And by that time, I hadn't really even told my family, a lot of my family. And I thought, well, rather than, you know, have it come out as some scary thing and I'm going to die, it would be better to come out. And actually, excuse me, it was very healthy because it's getting it off your chest, and I do believe that we create illnesses through our emotions, and parts of our body are related to that. Excuse me. Talking about emotions.
That what is related? Say that again.
When you keep it in Chinese medicine, they believe that certain parts of your body relate to different illnesses. Like, you'll notice that, for instance, when I went through a divorce, I got asthma, which I've never had before, and they say that the lungs are the center of grief. And I've noticed with friends, if they're going through sadness, they often get really bad colds or pneumonia, and children get stressed, they get asthma, and I happen to believe that. And then I was at a wonderful meeting the other day where this man does your heart's virtue, where he tells you about your heart's virtue, and they've discovered, I'm sorry, I'm ranting here, but your heart actually is not just muscle, it has tissue in it as well, so you are feeling, because your brain tissue is in your actual muscle of your heart. So when we feel something, we are actually.
Yeah.
And that's why our whole body feels and thinks. And they say the liver is the seat of anger, and you often find people that are angry.
The only objection I have to that, which I believe in the mind-body connection, I do, because I think that stress levels can be raised and your immune system can be lowered because of that.
Absolutely.
But the way some people say, oh, you're this type of cancer personality, etc., it almost sounds like you're blaming the person for getting it.
No, I don't.
That's the part that bothers me about that particular philosophy.
No, I don't blame myself and I don't blame anything else. It just made sense to me. When I went, one of my friends took me to see a therapist when I was diagnosed, and the first thing she said to me was, you need to stop breastfeeding the world. You need to, you know, wean everybody off you. And it just struck a chord in me, and whether it was just perfect for me. It made sense to me.
To you.
Yeah.
And, you know,
yeah.
I don't take blame for that or anything, but I do.
It doesn't explain, like, the high levels of breast cancer in Nassau County in Long Island.
For it doesn't. No, of course
so,
not.
So, you know what I mean? So this is
the only
take
reason.
It with a grain of salt is all
well,
I would
have to investigate as well.
But all these things are... You know, when you're healing and going through an illness like that, it helps to have these visions, and they help with the healing.
And what helps you
make sure read the books?
That being, everyone believes that the power of positive thinking assists in everyone's recovery.
Yes. Yeah. But it's like anything, sorry to interrupt you, it's like believing in God or Buddha or whatever you choose to believe in. It's your thoughts that create the process of healing.
Exactly.
And whatever you choose to make that, it's the positive thought.
Do you like feng shuiing? Right. How do you feel about that?
Oh, I do like it, but it's really very practical and very common sense when you think about it. I mean, you don't want a doorway with a stair or into your bedroom where people open the door and see you, and you don't want a bookcase behind your head so it falls on your head.
What's with the aquarium on top of the fireplace?
To counteract the fire, you put water.
So then you heat up the fish?
I'm putting a glass of water up there.
Go ahead. Just going to tell you, yesterday my daughter Lily and I were flipping through the stations, and Grease was on with you as Sandy. It is as wonderful now. Our thanks to Olivia Newton-John. My heart is full with her. Her album, Stronger Than Before, is in Hallmark Gold Crown stores. And stick around because Olivia will be singing her latest hit, Stronger Than Before, later in the show. We'll be right back. Have a great day, everyone, and take a little time to enjoy the view. But first, here to sing the title track off her new CD, Stronger Than Before, here is Olivia Newton-John.
Survived so many things, from broken hearts to shattered dreams. In every wall I found an open door. I'd miss a step, I'd learn to dance, come back again with half a chance. Shine with such amazing grace, strong.